بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. Today during the درس القرآن it was emphasized that every person should try to read سورة الواقعية every night. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم has said من قرأ سورة الواقعية كل ليلة، one who reads سورة الواقعية every night لم تصبه فاقة، poverty will not reach him. And obviously when a person reads سورة الواقعية every night he will not only acquire this virtue, he will also acquire all the other virtues mentioned in other hadiths. For example, من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله به حسنة والحسنة بعشر أمثالها. When a person reads a letter, a harf, a letter from the glorious Quran, Allah will grant him 10 rewards for every letter. So when a person reads Suratul Mulk, which comprises of 30 verses, and only Allah knows how many letters, so he will acquire the reward of 10 rewards upon every harf. Ta, ba, ra, ka. There are 5 letters. So 50 rewards on only tabaraka. So Allah will grant us the goodness of the hereafter and also the goodness of this world. Allah will save us from poverty. So everybody should make a point of reciting Suratul Mulk. Whenever we have problems in life, we resort to worldly solutions. But we as Muslims should resort to first and foremost religious solutions and then worldly solutions. So we can do both at the same time, and we should have more yaqeen and more faith in the religious solutions over the worldly solutions. Another surah which every person should recite on a daily basis is Suratul Yasin. Right from childhood we are taught in the madrasa, we are taught by our parents that we should recite Suratul Yasin daily in the morning. So after dawn any time in the morning, if you wake up early for tahajjud salat and as soon as the dawn breaks, and even before Fajr you can recite it. It's not necessary that you recite it only after Fajr. Any time after dawn in the morning. And the virtue of reciting Suratul Yasin, there are many virtues. One very important virtue is that whoever recites Surah Yasin at the beginning of the day, قُضِيَتْ حَوَائِجُهُ, all his needs of the day will be fulfilled. So this is where I want to leave all of you with. Two lessons only, very simple. Suratul Yasin, majority of us know by heart. And if we don't know by heart, then we should try to memorize it by heart. I visited a country long time ago, quite a few years ago, and my host, his name was Hafiz. Everybody said Hafiz, Hafiz, Hafiz. So his name was Hafiz. I thought he was Hafiz of the Quran, that's why they called him Hafiz. So I asked him, when I and him, we were only two of us there. I said one day, I said, how long did it take you to complete the Quran? I'm not a Hafiz of the Quran. So I said, why does everybody call you Hafiz? He said, my name is Hafiz. So I said, you are fooling everybody. You are fooling me as well that you are not Hafiz and you are taking the title of Hafiz. So he said, what shall I do? I said, become Hafiz. So he said, at this age, I'm 60. I said, learn the heart of the Quran. And then we will assume that you have completed the whole Quran. And I said, the heart of the Quran is Yasin Sharif. He said, that will be too difficult for me. I said, very simple. Daily learn one verse only. And Alhamdulillah, he managed to learn Surah Yasin. He has passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him, grant him maghfirat. So, where there is will, there is way. Man jadda wajada, one who strives succeeds. Anything, nothing is difficult. All you need is resolution. When you resolve, then the mercy of Allah descends and the nusrat of Allah. So on a daily basis, Yasin Sharif in the morning and recite Suratul Mulk any time from after Maghrib until we retire to bed. Suratul Waqiyah. And if we recite Suratul Mulk also, again between Maghrib and before we retire to bed, then Allah will save us from the punishment of the grave. So these three surahs I'm leaving you all with. Surah Yasin every morning, Suratul Mulk and Suratul Waqiyah. And it won't take more than 5 to 7 minutes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. May Allah grant immense khair and barakah in this nikah. And may Allah increase the taqwa of the bride and the bridegroom. May Allah make this union a means of strengthening their deen. May Allah make this union a means of helping each other in deen and dunya both. And may Allah make this union a means of providing sukoon for each other. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this union a means of pious progeny and the khair and the barakah of this world and the hereafter. Inshallah. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا اغفر لنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك، يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم احفظنا من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم بارك لنا فيما عطيتنا وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت لنا. اللهم بارك لهم فيما رزقتهم واغفر لهم وارحمهم. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وأغننا بفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم ألف بينهما كما ألفت بين الصالحين والصالحات وكما ألفت بين الطيبين والطيبات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا ورشدا. يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين. Have mercy upon all of us. Have mercy upon the whole ummah. Have mercy upon the whole of humanity. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us all forgiveness. O Arhamur Rahimeen, save us all from calamities. Save us all from coronavirus. O Arhamur Rahimeen, save us from the calamities of this world and the calamities of the hereafter. Save us from worldly calamities. Save us from deeni calamities. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant shifa to all the sick. هو أرحم الراحمين. remove the difficulties of those who are in difficulties. هو أرحم الراحمين. those who have neared their death, grant them حسن خاتمة. هو أرحم الراحمين. those who have passed away, grant them جنة الفردوس. هو أرحم الراحمين. هو أرحم الراحمين. هو أرحم الراحمين. for as long as you keep us alive, keep us with Iman, keep us on Islam. when you take us from this world, take us with Iman, take us with حسن خاتمة. take us whilst you are happy with us. take us with wilaya, take us with maqam siddiqiyat. Wa rahmur rahimin, make all the stations of the hereafter easy for everyone. grant us jannat al firdaus, save us from fire, the fire of jahannam. grant us all the good of this world and the good of the hereafter. save us from all the evil of this world and the evil of the hereafter. Wa rahmur rahimin, grant immense barakah in this nikah. grant immense khair in this nikah. Wa rahmur rahimin, grant immense barakah and khair to both the bridegroom and the bride. Wa rahmur rahimin, strengthen the bond of love between both of them. Wa rahmur rahimin, strengthen the bond of affection between both of them. Wa rahmur rahimin, grant them both the tawfiq to look after each other. Grant them both the ability to fulfill the rights of each other. Wa rahmur rahimin, wa rahmur rahimin, all the supplications that were made by your beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the occasion of nikah during his lifetime, grant all those, accept all those supplications on behalf of the bridegroom and the bride. Wa rahmur rahimin, grant us all khair and barakah and save us from all calamities. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Rabbi ighfir warham wa anta khairur rahimin. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.